Sometimes, no matter how much I want to finish a project, everything goes wrong. I need to finish a project to feel fulfilled, and it has to be within the same day or the next. Otherwise, I lose the connection to it. And today, so many things went wrong that I actually thought I would not finish the project. It all started with a plan to collaborate with Mariah and Patricia from PM Studio. The challenge was to use each other's scraps in a video. They would send me some scraps from their studio and I would send them some from mine. I will link their video at the end of my video, but first let me tell you what happened. I received the package in the mail and I take them out of the package and lay them on my table. And the first challenge for me is to figure out what I'm going to create with scraps. But luckily, the idea comes quickly. I would collage the art pieces into an art journal page. In my case, an 8x10 Joggles Discbound journal. I just used the matte medium to glue and seal the scraps randomly on the page, without thinking about composition. I had a general vision of how I wanted my project to be, and it felt so freeing to just glue and paste. This part goes so smoothly and turns out so nicely. I truly think this project is going to create itself. Little did I know that wasn't the case. Even the next small step goes according to plan, so I feel I'm on a roll. I heat dry the collage, but before the matte medium is fully dry, and while it still feels tacky to the touch, I take gold foil and using my fingernail, create gold scratch marks on my background. It felt like this project needed a bit of gold, and foiling randomly was the perfect technique to achieve that, as it would add so much texture and color. The next few steps is where things go sideways. The premise of my idea is to cover up some of the collaged area while leaving some of it with the colorful design intact. And to do that, I decide to create a clear texture over the collaged area using one of my stencils and gloss gel. Since the gel dries clear, the technique would allow the gel to seal the collaged area underneath the stencil pattern by creating a resist to any medium I add on top, thinking that this technique that I've done many times in the past will work perfectly. You will soon see that wasn't the case. But first, I need to let it dry. In the meantime, I work on the focal point. I had envisioned flowers, so I use my Cricut machine to cut some flowers so I can use them in the art journal. But, and I don't know what was I thinking, I decide to not only cut the flowers, but to teach myself how to foil them too, a technique that I have never done before. I had just gotten the Cricut foiling kit and I wanted to try it out. Plus, the gold foil would match the gold on the background perfectly. Trying a new technique can be challenging and time-consuming. How many times do we buy a product or we see somebody use it and we want to try the same technique and it doesn't go as planned? Don't get me wrong, it wasn't so hard to foil the flowers. That was actually the easy part. But I kept on making silly mistakes, like not putting the tape that holds the foil the proper way, or even forgetting to change the blades in between. It took me many frustrating tries and a few hours, but I finally foil and cut a few flowers. By now, I'm a foil expert. And when I try it on my next project, I don't make the same mistakes. I want to color my foiled flowers. And oh my God, everything goes wrong here. First, I forget to add clear gesso to protect my cardstock. So when I start applying the magical powders, the paper absorbs the color too much. I quickly add clear gesso and dry it. Then I realize I should have used watercolor markers instead of magicals, because when I add the darker colors, they are too pigmented. I try to save it by using some watercolor pencils, but it's too late. And the flowers look blah. Basically, ruined. I have spent so many hours foiling that I wasn't going to redo them today. So I have to think of another idea. And I feel extremely frustrated at this point. And I don't know about you, but when I feel frustrated, It's like a snowball that just gets bigger and bigger and bigger until I just need a break. I leave the flowers for a bit and I get back to my background, which I still think it's going to work. I haven't really realized that it's not. And using the Magicals, I start wetting my background, letting the watercolor effect drip down the page. I've done this technique so many times and it always turns out so beautiful. The main idea was that the Magicals will run through the gel texture and create darker shadows, while the clear texture would highlight the collage behind it. Well, guess what? It does not go as planned. It all becomes a big mishmash, and it is as if you can't see the difference between the pattern, the color, or the collage. It all looks the same. So I wipe off as much of the color as I can, and I stop. At this point, I don't know what to do. It's 5 p.m. and I feel defeated, as I can't start a new project because I don't have enough scraps left. And that feeling that I need to finish a project is bugging me. I decide to take a break and go have dinner with my family, thinking I will just finish it another day. But when I'm done eating dinner, I get this gnawing feeling in the pit of my stomach that if I don't finish it today, I don't know if I'll get back to it because I have a very busy weekend, and if I wait until Monday, I will lose that connection to my vision, and I don't really want that. So exhausted and all, I haul myself into my art room and I think of another idea. I browse through the Cricut design space and find a silhouette flower design that might be perfect for my page. I cut it out and glue it to my page using gel medium. I then remember that my original vision wasn't to have foiled flowers, but to have silhouette flowers that would show the collage pattern inside, kind of like a window. And this flower design is perfect for that. To make the collage more prominent, I use white gesso to cover the negative space around the flowers. This helps the flower stand out, as it creates what I wanted to do all along with the gloss gel and the stencil. But as you can see, you can't even tell that I had put a stencil pattern in the background. So if you're recreating this project, you can skip that step. Now it was coming along, but I didn't want to get my hopes up just yet. So I continue by outlining my flower edges with black. Good thing I remember that for textured backgrounds, the only thing that works is the Write All Stabilo pencil, as it literally writes on anything. I then add some script stamping with archival ink and glue the perfect quote. Creating might seem difficult sometimes, but it's in those moments that we have to remember the reasons why we create, to help us in those moments that we can't create. Here's a video where I talk just about that. And right here is the video that PM Studio created with my scraps.